Hello everyone, and welcome to this mini tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to recreate this photo animation using Linearity Move. Let's start by creating a new file. Go to File, New. Select the resolution as square and leave frame rate as 30 fps. Click Confirm. Let's create a new scene. Go to New Scene, click Import. Select the file provided, called photoanimation.curve. Click Open. Here in the import panel, you will see as many artboards as there are on your curve file, which in this case is just one. Click the artboard and drag and drop it onto the scene builder line. Click Import. Double-click the scene to enter the timeline. You will see on the left side that you have all your layers. We have an image and we have the three lines of text divided into groups. Let's start animating. The first thing we want to do to create the rotation effect on this image is to create some circles inside our canvas. Go here onto the left, where the animate button is. Click it to switch to design mode. When we are on design mode, we can add as many elements as we want to our design without affecting the timeline. To create a circle, go in the toolbar here on the left. Select the shape tool. You can select different shapes in the shape tool. We're going to use oval. To create a circle, just click and drag and hold shift while doing so to create a regular shape. Click, holding shift and drag. I want this circle to be exactly the same size as the canvas, so I'm going to use the style panel here to input the right amount. Use the lock icon to have a proportion resizing and then input your amount. 1080 will do. Also center the circle using the align buttons here. I want to copy and paste this circle a couple of times and resize it. To do so, you can either copy using the keyboard by clicking Command C to copy and Command V to paste, or you can also duplicate the layer by clicking Command D. To resize the circle, you can either use the handles on the side of the shape or input another value here in the style panel. If you're going to resize using the resizing box, make sure that you hold Shift and Option while doing so, so the shape will scale proportionally and towards the center. Let's scale the third layer, like so. And then we're going to duplicate it another time, Command D, and then resize it, holding Shift and Option. Perfect. Now we want to insert the image in each circle by using masks. To do so, first we have to duplicate the image as many times as we have ovals. To do so, click Command D 4 times. Here in the layer panel, you can see all your elements. We want to drag these 4 to the top. Position one of the images on top of the circle, then select both the image and the circle by holding Shift, and then right-click and select Mask Selection. Do the same for all the circles. Let's move the groups underneath the text. This will come in handy later. So now we want to start animating this rotation effect. Click on the design button to go back to animate mode. Then drag the playhead on the timeline from 0 to second number 2. Select the first of the circles and using the handles that you see at the top, the rotation handle, just rotate the circle as much as you want. Do the same for all the circles. Just make sure that when the first one was rotated towards the right, we're going to rotate the second one towards the left, and so on. The third one towards the right, and the last one towards the left, in an alternate manner. Let's preview our animation. Bring the playhead back to zero and press play. Perfect. Let's bring the playhead to second number 4, and now we're going to rotate each circle the opposite direction for a good amount. The first one from right to left, the second one from left to right, and so on. Let's preview the animation. Perfect. Now that we're done, we can also remove the stroke on the mask layers. Simply select the mask layer and then go to the style panel and deactivate the stroke. Do this for all the circles. Now that everything is organized, I'm going to group all the elements that contain an image by selecting them. Hold shift while you select all of them and then right click and create group selection. Now I will create an animation that will apply to all the group. First, move the playhead back to second 2. As all the circles rotate for the first time, I also want the group to resize all at once. Then bring the playhead to second 4. And as everything goes back the other direction, we're going to shrink everything to the center of the canvas to make it as small as possible. Hold Shift and Option while you do so. Perfect. Let's preview the animation. We also want the last image in the group to disappear before everything shrinks back down. So we're going to select it and we're going to add a preset called Fade Out. You see that using the preset created an opacity transition that we're going to modify so it's very quick and it will just happen in between the two animations. This way the square image will disappear before everything shrinks down into circles. Now we're going to animate the text lines. Bring the playhead back to second 0. Select the groups with the text lines in them. Hold Shift while you click on them to select all at the same time. Then we're going to use a combination of presets here in the effect panel. Select Fade In for them to appear, and then Scale In for them to grow bigger as they appear. We want this animation to be at the end of the timeline. So group everything and then move the animation bar towards the end. This way we just moved everything with just one click. We're also going to offset the animation so they don't appear all at the same time. This should do. Let's preview our animation now. This looks amazing. We just need to tweak a couple of things. For example, here at the end, we want the circle to disappear before the text comes in. That's very easy to do. Click the group with all the images and add another preset. We're going to use Fade Out. Let's preview the animation again. And that's done. Click File, Export. And don't forget to share your results with us. Thank you for joining me today. I'll see you in the next tutorial.